Alright, so we're back at it after a long, kind of a long hiatus from this game, just because I was doing a lot of training. So, we're going to get two evolving Pokemon that I've pretty much just saved for rare candying. So let's... Nope. I'm not going to use the ones I trained for the Elite Four to go through the that final cave. I trained him up to 59, which was a pain in the butt. Trained him to 58, which is also a pain in the butt. But we can rare candy them. This was the one that was in the daycare center that I put in a very long time ago. And we can rare candy him again. Now we got Aggron, one of my favorite rock Pokemon. A little steel. Alright, this time I got Bagon. Trained him up too, and caught him in the Meteor Falls cave. I saved the evolutions for the stream. There we go. Got a Salamence. Alright, so I'm not going to use them for the cave. I'm still going to use Sceptile and Swampert. See, there you go. I'm gonna use that team for the Elite Four. Did a lot of training. Alright. We're gonna go through the cave of Evergrande. I just got to double check to see if I have all the HMs. I think I need a flash. No one. Except Septile, which I'm not going to do that. Maybe Wailord. He's used for Regis anyway, so. We're gonna try to beat the Elite Four tonight. If we still have time, we can do, legendary hunting. I think we'll need Waterfall. Waterfall, Surf, and Flash. It would be very weird if he can't learn Flash. Is he pretty much just a His whole lore of Chin Chow is illuminating stuff, so yeah, he better learn Flash. Alright, here we go. Wally. The presentation in the Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire of the final fight with Wally was really good. Of course he uses full restore. Everybody uses potions in this game. Gonna try to one-shot me. Yep. Almost. There we go. So many resistances to grass. Yeah, fucking poison. Alright, get rid of my poison, because I'm really annoyed by that. Leaf Blade. Magneton. I resist that. Of course he does. Might as well do it too. Everybody's doing it. All right, Gardevoir. That's where the psychic came from. Good thing I have pursuit. What's with everybody using double team? Oh my god. Oh my god. That was one double team killing me. There we go. All right. Get back on track here. Roselia. Why does everybody have to have a status move? And a full restore. See, everybody uses them. Maybe I should have brought a poison bow or a steel type with me so that way they can stop doing this. Alright. Good thing I got a lot of antidotes. Hariyama. Oh, okay. Didn't want me to catch him. The Hariyama. Well, he made it easier. It's like he wanted to be in the Ultra Ball. Swellow. Of course it resists grass too, huh? God, I can't wait until I can teach Sceptile how to use Thunder Punch. Get rid of all these pesky birds. Steel type. Yeah, it's just Leaf Blade. Not very effective, but hopefully I can get a crit out of it. Kadabra. I can handle that. I have Pursuit after all. Thank you. Okay. I believe it's south. Another Hariyama. Luckily, I don't need you. Golbat. Golbat. Is a sand slash something I'm good at against? Something I'm not good against, but I am gonna switch because that's a little bit harder to beat. Tropius. Also another flying Pokemon. Let me guess, I'm paralyzed? Oh, not yet. I will be. Oh, of course. Full restore. Have to do that. Have to full restore every battle. Bat. That's all that's here, really. That's all it's gonna give me, Golbat. Nothing new. Sableye. That I can handle. Absol is also something I can handle. To Hariyama again. Like I don't need that for the 20th time. Attack turn. Also resists Sceptile. Ugh. This is why choosing Treecko is like hard mode. It's like stuff like that. See? Another flying Pokemon. And this one has Protect. To make sure you don't hit him first turn. Much as I want to face him, I want to be able to beat the Elite Four tonight. All right, made it. I feel like these guys are not necessary because you need the 8th badge to use Waterfall, and Waterfall is the primary way of getting over here. So I feel like those guys were probably unnecessary. Alright. Super team. I'm probably gonna put XP share on Sceptile. And I think have my super team that I trained up for a couple hours. Probably more than a couple hours. If I'm not mistaken, the bug one is up first. Or dark. Either way, I'm gonna throw him there. Seventeen in bag. I think this should be fine. Oh, I forgot to heal. Well. We'll just use this. He should be easy to beat. He's dark, and I think some bug in there. Or was it grass? I don't remember. Anyway, Sky Uppercut. I thought this was a cool move, because it can beat up anything that bounces and flies. Blaze Kick. Absol. Sky Uppercut. Bring in Sceptile for this. Leaf Blade. Cacturne. Oh, we're switching back. Blaze Kick. I think Cacturne is a very underrated Pokemon. I think I used him in one of the GameCube games. How's it going? Zoppy92? Is that how you say it? Okay. Alright. That's number two. Ghost. Yeah, which one has... You have it. And who is my backup? It might be Septal that is the backup. Alright. Gonna be a crunch sweep, hopefully. Crunch. Okay. I don't like it when they're just wasting a turn on protect. How? Oh, you're dead. I don't remember if switching out helps. Shadow Ball hitting pretty hard. And you have a Citrus Berry. Come on, crit him. Crit him. Leaf Blade. Crit him. There we go. I don't know if switching out got rid of Curse. But I think I need to bring him back in regardless. Crunch. No. I don't think he can do anything. Increase my critical hit rate. Oh, that's dirty. Why do you have to have a double team? Crit him, please. Nope. Get out of here. So, I don't know why in this game it's either been status moves, potion every battle, and double team the entire time. That's a good way to stall out the game. I wonder why people put like hundreds of hours into just one copy of it. Alright. Let's see. I think HP wise, I'm okay. That was number two. Ice. Let's throw Aggron into it. Steel is good against ice types. Glacia. Oh, that's a different story. Iron Tail. Miss. Iron Tail. Because he's bulky. Iron Tail. Miss. There we go. We're gonna switch it. I'd rather have Blaziken in, just sweep with Sky Uppercut. Oh, I hope he can survive that. He's good. Oh my god, he missed. Didn't expect that. Way to go. There we go. That way I can bring Blaziken back in. Sky Upper cut him to space. Hopefully. He woke up? My god. This is not fair. This time, stay asleep. It's Sky uppercut this guy to space, please. Almost. Citrus. There's probably a potion in that. Oh my god. Repeat for performance. I focus energy. I miss. Sky uppercut, and he surfs me to death. That won't miss. Alright. Blaylee should not be hitting Aggron hard, so that gives me time to revive. That's not gonna do much. Alright, don't miss it, please. Again, not fair. This run has been completely unfair. Full heal. And I probably have a couple berries at defrost. KO him, please. Thank you. Alright, hopefully he doesn't keep missing. Guy uppercut this fool to space. Cool. Boom, hit him with a blaze kick. There we go. That was more painful than it should have been. It's like they lowered the accuracy of all my moves. Even the ones that's supposed to hit 100%. Hyper potion. You. You. And you. Alright, I believe Drake is up next. Swamper have what I think he has? No. Probably give it to him though. It'll probably be replaced in the future with either Ice Beam or Ice Punch. I forgot to switch. Good thing I didn't do. Thing I hit him with this one and not switch out. And I miss. Come on, Aggron. Smack. Yep, stalling out the game. Kingdra. Let's just throw you in here. God. Why is the accuracy lower on everything? There we go. And Blizzard's already low on accuracy, you don't need to do it more. Wow, good thing I beat him. Alright. Blizzard should be one-shotting this thing. If it can hit. Hit him. Finally. Ligon. This should also one-shot him. Don't miss the blizzard. That crit me? All right. That shouldn't crit me. Or that shouldn't have done so much damage. For sure. Even with a crit. Come on, Swampert. They're killing me here. Thank you. All right, sweet. I have 3 chances to hit him. He's dragging and flying. Should do 4 times. There we go. Not as bad as the last battle, but still annoying that I keep missing. Alright. I should probably switch my order. Okay. I'll have to face Champion Wallace. Crit him. That would be great. Almost. At least that wasn't a crit, so. If I did crit him, it would have been one-shotted. But I have another chance. Use that full restore. Yep. As expected. See? Crit, and he's dead. Milotic. Hopefully I can crit this too. Nope. Shockwave. Oh. One of these Pokemon. Okay. We'll just set up for a sweep then. You have Toxic? Oh my god. I remember early gens where you can put Toxic on any Pokemon. It was like absolutely unnecessary because most VGC teams at the time kept putting Toxic on Pokemon. Which, you know, kind of ironic because a lot of the players are Toxic. Do not have a full restore. Alright. I think this one should do it. Yeah, of course you would toxic me. Let's stop doing that, huh? Shockwave. Yep, keep toxing me. Hits you before you can recover. I'm pretty sure you have toxic too. This should one-shot you. Plus 5 stab psychic. Ludicolo. We'll keep you in. I gotta recover everything. That's fine. Shockwave doesn't miss, so... do that all you want. Oh, that's right. He double teamed, that's why I missed. Shockwave. Screw your double team. Trying to see how long I can outlast. I have the Calm Mind buffs and I don't want to get rid of that. Oh, this should be four times. And a plus five Calm Mind. Rip. All right. I'm the Hoenn League champion. Let's go. I'm the champion. With my dream team of Hoenn. Reptile, Swampert, Blaziken, Gardevoir, Salamence, Aggron. And me. League champion, congratulations. I don't know why But this run of it, Pokemon Emerald, was the most annoying. I don't remember it. So many potion using status effects and what was it? Double teams. There were so many in this run. It felt very unnecessary. Anyway, I'm gonna do a legendary catching. And some Battle Frontier stuff. And I think also, while doing those kind of streams, I'm probably also going to do Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness, because it's one of my favorite GameCube games. And it's technically it's a mainline game, because you can transfer over to the GBA games. You can use your GBA team for the battles. So, yeah. It's just showing all my Pokedex entries. Out of 156 I've seen, I caught 108. And I'm pretty sure most of those were just because of evolutions. I feel like you can make a poke rap out of Pokemon being shown. Awada. The end. It's Dad. This gives me a ticket to Battle Frontier. Oh, that is the TV was talking about Latios and Latias. And you get to choose which one you want. I think. Alright, it's giving me the gnat. National Dex. All right. Gotta get my other Pokemon here. Uchiana. You know, Poochyena is, I think Poochyena gets better with each game. It's like in Scarlet and Violet, he's pretty good, I think. Alright, we'll put you back in. All right. I'm going to transfer these into a newer game. Along with any Pokemon that I feel I want to do that with. That way I can do that final transfer thing. Still gotta do trade evolutions. Alright. I actually hope, I don't remember where, but I do think I can catch a Ditto in this game. Alright, let's go to Lily Cove. I think that's where he told us to meet him. Either that or Sleepport. Okay. Lovey-dovey power. I think that couple is also... No, but I think someone's used that same wording in Diamond, Pearl, Platinum. Everything has focus energy, but not needed for them. I'm battling these trainers now because I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get to them later. Don't know where the amulet coin is. Kinda wish I knew. Of course. Get paralyzed. Yeah, I'm slow as heck. I believe I'm in cabin 2. Is that Mr. Briny? Hey, it is. Contests I ought to do at least a couple times. I remember I made like my own, like when I was a kid, I made my own like contest only Pokemon, which I probably will do again. Like I remember I bred them for contest use only. I did it for Torchic for sure. He has 6 skitties. They're all like random levels too. I know it's kind of boring in slaughtering different Pokemon or different Skitties, but it's a slow game. Oh, this guy has Delcatty too. Good to know he changed it up a little bit. I hope you don't have six Pokemon too. Okay, she has one. Did I knock on the door? No. I just barge right in asking for a battle. Zangoose. Need that soothe bell and amulet coin. Soothe bell for all the friendship evolutions. Well, that's a good thing I was on this boat then. Fight me. Fight me, sailor. And cruel. Well, you got a Leaf Blade coming. False white. No. I think I should be good. Machoke. Leaf Blade. Fight me. Caliper. Okay. Slam. Miss, of course. Slam. There we go. Stockpile. Big attack. Oh, two protects in a row. Why? Takedown. No, thank you. Machoke. Gotta be something here. Yep, leftovers. It'll be necessary for Battle Frontier builds. And I think I'm done here. Alright. Battle Frontier. This place was always so cool to me. I remember I had almost all the frontier badges, or symbols, I guess. That's what they were called here. It's like playing the game over, but like, it's meant for VGC players. Let's just say that. Like, if they remade this whole place in like a game, whether it's on the Switch or future Pokemon consoles, this was like the place for VGC. And it's why it's so underrated. You got facilities, you have the Frontier Pass. Shows you all the facilities have different, you know, tactics and all that. Like, there's different ways of doing this, in a way. Like, the Battle Pyramid was crazy. Battle Pike, test your luck with the different paths. Rental teams. I think this one had to do with natures. No, actually this one was natures. Don't remember that one. This was like tournament style. And this is just regular Battle Tower. And then you earn symbols. I think 50 was silver and then 100 was gold. Or something like that. That's how you get battle points. It was great, honestly. I liked doing the Battle Pike. That was like my favorite. The Battle Pyramid was the worst because you have to go through like this maze, battle trainers. You had no access to items, so by the time you got to Brandon, you were like, your Pokemon were like pretty much beaten up. And he'd just wipe your team right then and there. So you had to actually think carefully. Okay, that's vitamins. Held items. Nope. Dolls for your room or base. Kind of useless. And more aesthetics that you don't need. Where's the tutors? I know they're like in a regular house. Oh yes, and this pretty much was the record haul. Like, see how long your streak was. How many times you've beaten it, stuff like that. Is it this place? No. Yeah. I know, like, post-game, I hung out here the most. And it was really fun. It was like the first time actually doing like actual competitive builds, because you kind of needed them for to beat the frontier. There's a room with like three women just sitting, chilling out. That's not these guys. And I think you can also do some of this with your with a friend. I think. Okay, trying to find the that's the battle factory. Trying to find the house with find the house with like the move tutors. Oh, it's Scott. Sweet, two battle points. Was it this one? No, I don't think so. There should be like three women sitting next to each other or near each other. Don't think this is it. This one was the hardest one. Oh, it must be this one, I think. No. Pseudo Wudo. God, I can't find him. Oh well. I am gonna see if, if something, or I can catch a Ditto. I believe you can catch a Ditto past this. Yep. Need Ditto. I need to switch to a weaker Pokemon. Like Numel. And then do this. If I can catch one ditto, that would be fine. There we go. Okay. For this instance, I need to get to the fossil. There we go. Needed the other fossil. I got one ditto. That was good enough for right now. Now I can get the other fossil Pokemon. Which is really nice when they can... when they can give you both at the post game. I also got to get my Beldum. Alright, we got to put one Pokemon away. Put you away for now. All right, go claim our Laleep. Okay, we got our Laleep. Which will eventually turn into a Cradilly. Let's head to Moss Deep and claim our Beldum. Alright, gotta belt him. He left that belt him for me. And I believe he's in Meteor Falls, but like a deep part of Meteor Falls. Calm nature. Oy. I think I'd have to breed the Beldum just to get it the right nature for the battle palace, I think. I don't know if breeding mechanics, or I don't know if Masuda method is for Emerald yet. I feel like it isn't. Alright. So, I guess we can hunt for Groudon. So, depending on the weather, you can catch Groudon and Kyogre in different locations. So, grab another Pokemon. Grab the Salamence. Probably also grab more Ultra Balls. Because Ultra Ball is my favorite ball. Sure, let's max out. That way I don't drop as much money. Alright, so let's try 105. Oh, I chose the wrong place. I don't know what I was doing. If it's raining or sunshine, then one of the Pokemon are there. I am going to super repel, because I don't want to deal with that annoying stuff. Okay. It is not raining there, or sunshine. So let's try, let's go to 125 now. Is behind 7, 29. Mountain 25 is behind Moss Deep. I don't see any weather issues. Whoops. Okay. I'm confused now. I'm gonna fly to spots that I think there could be bad weather. So I feel like this cave opens up for a ground on at least. Okay, I think there was another method to doing this. It always rains here, so I don't count that. I believe it was here you can find out where the weather is. Like, I think he would tell you, like, oh, there's a drought recorded at 114. Okay. So, let's go over there. Over here. Yeah. As you can see, the screen effects going off. It means Groudon is nearby. I think this is the waterfall location. Yeah, it's appearing to be the waterfall location. I'm pretty sure, like, the other location's here. Yeah, might as well fly back and get my my waterfall Pokemon. Wait, do I have it? No. Don't think I need any of these TMs or HMs, so we'll leave you behind for now. Here you are. I'm gonna save just in case. I'm gonna save after like every two steps. Groudon's one of my favorite legendaries. He was kind of OP in this gen. He can use Solar Beam, he can use Fire Punch, or Fire Blast, Flamethrower really, Earthquake, other stuff. So just in case I kill him, I saved it. Okay. He also has rest, by the way. In case I crit him. Perfect. This will be Pokeball Throwing Simulator. Solar Beam look cool in this game. He is gonna rest though. After he realizes he can barely do anything to me. Oh, Fire Blast. That's not good. I can resist it. I'm dragging. That's right, yes, fissure. I'm flying dragon. I resist it. He is gonna rest at some point. Almost. Also want to make note that you can't use these kind of legendaries for the battle frontier, which kind of bugged me, but it made sense. Did not make sense that the battle frontier brains had him. Don't burn me again. Okay. That's fine. I can hit him with the three dragon claws. All right, here we go. Two shake. You can keep solar beaming me, it's fine. And rest. Back to sleep. Back to sleep. I think that's his fifth rest. I think. I don't remember how much rest does, or how many power points his rest have. Oh, it has 10. Never mind. God. All he has is rest. Let's see. He's went through all his polar beams, fissures, and fire blasts. Actually, I'm just gonna start throwing ultra balls, really. I know the catch rate is nearly impossible in the green, but oh well.
It's gonna make him struggle to death. Because all he's gonna do is rest. What would really be funny is if I had like a Gardevoir with rest and in prison. That would be funny. I wish he didn't have rest though. You can give him bulk up, mud shot, didn't matter. Yep, he's struggling to death. Now he's on time limit. I got plenty of hyper potions, buddy. Haven't got a Master Ball. Means I didn't get it. Didn't pick it up off somewhere. But that's fine. I don't want it. Don't want it. Don't need it. I'd rather do it the old-fashioned way. Master Balls are only interesting in Nuzlocke. Come on, get in the ball. Your time's running out. If I don't catch it right now, I'm just gonna catch it off stream.
Actually, you know what? I'll probably not catch it off stream. Wow, he crit me. Crit me with struggle. Jesus. Come on, buddy, you're gonna die. Wow, he crit me. Crit me with a struggle. Well, I think this is the last Ultra Ball before he kills himself. Whenever. Getting awfully close. He's still alive. I'm pretty sure this is the last one. This time. Nope. Didn't even bother. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's dead. Well. Well, good thing we saved before. Well, I'm gonna end the stream here, because we did what was intended. We got through the cave and beat the Elite Four. Got a couple Pokemon. So yeah. I'm gonna end the stream here. Have a good night, everyone. And I'll see you in the next stream. Bye.